Hi, it's Nikki here from Happy Hormones for Life. And excuse me, today I'm talking about vitamin B12, benefits and symptoms and what you need to look out for deficiency, which is incredibly important to know. So what do you know about B12? I didn't know much about it before I studied nutrition. I knew it was something that you got from animal foods, but not much else. And it seems vitamin B12 gets ignored a lot in the medical world too. One personal example of this, my grandma was in and out of psychiatric hospitals for years. They said she used to go a bit crazy once in a while, and then she'd spend a few months in an institution because they did all the tests and they couldn't find anything wrong with her. It wasn't until years later that they discovered that she was B12 deficient. I mean, imagine her life, all those years, had they discovered that earlier. And my mum has pernicious anemia too, which I'm going to talk about. So I get tested every year to make sure I don't have any anything like that, obviously, because it is hereditary. So what does vitamin B12 do? Well, it produces healthy red blood cells that transport oxygen and nutrients around the body. So if you don't have healthy red blood cells, you're in trouble. So it's very, very important for that. It helps make your DNA. It's really vital for your heart, for your brain and your nervous system, and this is where we can often get symptoms. It helps make energy, and it helps detoxification of excess hormones like estrogen. It does a whole lot more, but those are the main things, and then those are the things that we tend to see symptoms around. So what are the common symptoms you'd be looking for? First one is fatigue, unexplained fatigue. Obviously, without those red blood cells going around the body, it can affect oxygen transport to your cells and make you very, very tired. Dizziness is another one. So if you feel wobbly when you get up too fast, or you feel dizzy going upstairs, or vertigo, balance problems, it could be that your B12 is low. Not always, but it's definitely worth checking. Brain fog and memory loss, when you haven't got enough B12, it can really affect your brain and cause fogginess, lack of focus, lack of concentration, that kind of stuff, and poor memory. Pins and needles is another common one, or numbness, and you get that usually in your hands or feet, another common symptom, so do get that, do bear that in mind. Clumsiness, confusion, and then the whole mood issues, mood swings, irritability, frustration, confusion, depression, very, very common with a B12 deficiency. Another symptom might be blurred vision, or kind of spots in front of your eyes, or light sensitive, or shadows, that kind of stuff. So definitely worth getting your B12 checked if that's the case. Dry skin, brittle nails, that kind of thing. And swollen or sore tongue, if you get that as well, it might be something you need to check. And sometimes there's a shortage of breath too when you sigh a lot. It's called the sighs. Again, definitely worth checking your B12. So it's because of those symptoms, it's really, really easy to miss or get misdiagnosed. You might be given antidepressants or some other treatment rather than get your B12 levels checked. And it's easy to miss because symptoms are common ones, like, you know, aches and pains, fatigue, mood issues, similar to getting older, similar to menopause. There's lots of different, obviously, those symptoms can be mixed up and due to different things. So it's always worth getting that B12 checked because you might be being put on the wrong medication. Long-term deficiency is very dangerous. You could be, that it can damage your nerves, you can risk paralysis and severe cognitive decline as well. So we really want to be making sure that we catch it early. There is a comprehensive symptoms checklist available on the homepage of the Pernicious Anemia Society. I've put a link to that in my blog, and the blog will be available on Friday. It's free to download, so you can have a look at that and see, and you could take that to your doctor if you want to try and persuade them to get you tested. Types of B12 deficiency, there's two main types. The first one I mentioned is pernicious anemia. Now this is an autoimmune condition where you lack a protein called intrinsic factor that the body produces to absorb B12 in the stomach from your food. Now people with pernicious anemia, they don't produce this intrinsic factor. So we don't really know why, but they have antibodies against it. So supplements are pretty useless because you just can't absorb them. So this is when you need to get it checked. If you're taking B12 supplements and there maybe just your levels aren't going up, and you're still getting symptoms, that's maybe that you've got this pernicious anemia type of deficiency. And that's when you're going to need injections, because supplements just don't cut it. The second one is B12, just normal B12 deficiency. And this is where you've got this intrinsic factor, but you're not getting enough B12 for other reasons. And that could be your diet, because B12 can only be found in animal foods. So vegans and vegetarians are particularly at risk. Studies that I've seen looked at showing that 50% of long-term vegetarians and 80% of vegans could be deficient in B12. So it's so important to get that checked and to supplement. Other things that can deplete your B12 are alcohol and some medications such as PPIs, acid suppressors. If you have reflux and things like that, metformin is another drug that can increase your risk of deficiency. And then things, gut issues, gut health, poor digestion. So if you've got low stomach acid or gastritis, if you've got IBS or Crohn's or ulcerative colitis, or if you've got leaky gut, inflammation, dysbiosis, like an underlying infection or imbalance, all of those things can affect your B12 absorption. So, you know, there are other things that we need to be looking at. So even if your diet is rich in B12 foods, you may not be absorbing it. And obviously we get worse at absorbing our nutrients as we get older, because our digestive juices get depleted. And it's thought amongst experts that around 40% of those over 60 could have B12 deficiency, and it does tend to be, you know, prevalent in older people. Again, misdiagnosis is routine, and testing is not often done for B12, so you do have to ask for it and push for it. Some doctors do it, but others don't. So, and I guess again, you're going to, you know, have symptoms that can mimic other conditions. The reference ranges are pretty large again, so that, you know, low levels can be classed as normal. Whereas a lot of B12 experts actually think you should have much higher levels than the reference range, and some experts are saying, you know, you want to be looking for levels above 450 pg per mil to be sort of in the right range. Also, the current blood tests don't really distinguish between the inactive and active forms of B12, so it's looking really at your serum levels of B12 and not your active levels. So again, if your blood levels are normal, it may not be that they're actually getting into the tissues. So treatment options: if you have pernicious anemia, you're going to need injections of B12, which you'll be able to get on the NHS or at your local health providers in your country. If you don't have pernicious anemia but are B12 deficient, then you're going to need to start eating B12 rich foods, that red meat, liver, fish, dairy, eggs, or if you don't want to do that, you've got a supplement. And you want to supplement with methylcobalamin. That is the most effective form of supplement. And sublingual tablets seem to have really good results. Sublingual tablets or sprays. Some clinics also offer IV infusions as well. If you can get those, that should boost your levels pretty quickly as well. So what do we do if you have any of these symptoms that I've talked about, or if you're over 60, I would be absolutely getting your active B12 levels tested. Plus your folate and your ferritin, and you can talk to us about that. We test that all the time, routinely, in our blood tests. If you're deficient, you want to identify whether it's pernicious anemia causing it or just B12 deficiency, because you're going to have different treatments for that, and then you're either going to get injections through your doctor or increase your levels through your diet or supplement and or supplements. Again, I hope that was useful. I really feel passionately about B12 because it's obviously close to my heart, and I really, really hope that you can get yourself tested if you're worried about it. So if you want to talk to us about getting tested or any other B12 or any other of our health tests or our one-to-one support, please do message me or contact me through the website, and we'll be here to help. I speak to you, hope you're well. I'll speak to you soon.